Bulky televisions, rusty bikes, and other rubbish littered the streets of Oskaloosa this week as part of the annual citywide cleanup. The free initiative kept city workers busy clearing curbs and hauling away waste. But as CRI's Jason Madison tells us, some residents were about to turn one man's trash into another man's treasure.
Oskaloosa's citywide cleanup is back, and residents took advantage.
I think this is the first time in 3 years, and there's quite a bit of junk out here.
A lot of people can't get to the dump, and we're more than happy to help them out.
City worker Matt Saville says he's glad the cleanup returned, but shocked by the amount of trash residents sat out.
One thing that we are surprised is that we didn't see a lot more sitting out, but with what we've had so far, it hasn't been so bad this week.
City workers picked up everything except tires, yard waste, batteries, and other hazardous materials. Over the course of 4 days, workers canvassed the community with six city dump trucks, eventually delivering their loads here at the county dump. However, some Oskaloosa residents found value in the so-called useless items.
One man's trash, that's another man's come up.
And brought them here. The Paul's Auto and Metals, located east of town on Highway 92.
Gives them a place to maybe make a little money on it.
Paul employee George Palmer says 1 ton of scrap metal is worth $180. That figure, broken down over an 8-hour span minus an hour for lunch, means a person will average more than $25 an hour.
It's helping us keep our doors open, and it's cleaning up Oskaloosa a little bit. You know, a lot of people got this stuff that they just lying around the yard.
Palmer says the company buys only non-ferrous metals and delivers it to recyclers. Non-ferrous metals are non-magnetic, such as aluminum, copper, and brass. Other things Paul's Auto and Metals also won't accept are appliances and sealed containers used to house hazardous materials, such as propane tanks and car cooling systems. For CRI Weekly News, I'm Jason Madison.
Palmer added that business has tripled over the past 2 weeks. He contributes that to the citywide cleanup and the warm weather.